Hey guys, it's Mike Chen and happy solar eclipse day. As many of you have heard so far, today's total solar eclipse is being heralded as an once in a lifetime event. But here's the thing, total solar eclipse occurs around every 18 months. So why is this one so once in a lifetime-y? Because technically it is an once in a lifetime event for some people, because for a total solar eclipse to happen again in the same exact location will take another 375 years. But this time the solar eclipse will travel across North America within viewing distance of over 200 million people. And also what's so special is that this solar eclipse is happening for the first time, at least around here, during the age of computers. And maybe more importantly to most of us, the age of Instagram and Facebook. So yeah, with this event basically turning into National Eclipse Day, definitely expect to see a lot of pictures on your social media feed. Also, here's the thing. The solar eclipse may be to scientists something remarkable to study, and it may be a really good photo op for the general public, but it also affects animals, marine life, and just in general causes some really strange things to happen. So in this video, we're gonna cover six really strange things that occur during a solar eclipse. Number six, animals become really weird, or even more weird. And this is because some animals tend to sleep once it gets dark, while nocturnal animals wake up. But since with the eclipse, the darkness only lasts for a little bit, it's like night and day happen for these animals in a matter of minutes, which really just messes with their internal clock and confuses the heck out of them. According to National Geographic, reports of unusual animal reactions to solar eclipses date back centuries. One of the earliest stories comes from an Italian monk named Ristoro di Arezzo, who described what happened during a total eclipse on June 3rd in the year 1239. He said, as the sun disappeared and the sky turned dark, all the animals and birds were terrified and the wild beasts could easily be caught. Also, according to astronomer Christoph Clavius, during an eclipse in Portugal in 1560, birds just fell out of the sky because, according to him, they were terrified of the sudden darkness. Number five, daytime stars. When total obstruction is achieved, depending on weather conditions, you may be able to see stars reappear in the sky. Normally, of course, stars are always present in the sky no matter what time of day. It just so happens that they are outshined by the sun's bright light. And another interesting occurrence that may happen is the appearance of some planets in the sky depending on their current alignment and the orbital distance from Earth. The most common planets that appear during an eclipse are Earth's closest neighbors, Mars, Venus, Mars, Mercury, Venus, Mars, and Jupiter. Number four, changing conditions. You know, you might want to bring a jacket because in the event of a total solar eclipse, conditions in the path of totality may change rapidly. However, other changes may also happen in the environment, such as a sharp drop in air temperature, which could be as much as 20 degrees. Next, breaking the laws of physics. According to Nobel Prize winning French economist Maurice Allais, a gravitational anomaly occurs only during a solar eclipse, which he later called the Allais effect. The way this came about was that in 1954, Allais observed over a 30-day period that the movement of pendulums moved faster than normal during a solar eclipse. This led him to believe that the laws of gravity needed to be changed because of this. And to this day, why this effect occurs is still a mystery. Next, shadow bands. Now, if you are one of the lucky ones in the path of a solar eclipse, take a piece of paper or look at any light-colored surface around you. In about a minute into the total eclipse, you will start to see rows of shadows moving rapidly on the ground. These are called shadow bands, and they basically look like little strips of shadows moving row after row, kind of like taking steps with the same amount of space in between them. According to NASA, this occurs because near totality, the image of the sun is only a thin crescent, which are about the same size as the atmospheric eddies as seen from the ground. And the bands are produced because the sun's image is longer in one direction than another. Finally, superstitions. Because a total solar eclipse is basically the sun slowly disappearing in the daytime, it was pretty terrifying to a lot of people, especially back in ancient times. So naturally, people created customs to deal with this phenomenon, and some of them are still practiced to this day. For example, in many Asian countries, people will run outside and bang on pots and pans, create a lot of noise in an effort to scare away the evil spirit that is covering up or attempting to swallow the sun. Eskimos turn their utensils upside down during a solar eclipse because it is believed that if you don't, you will be infected with a disease. And this one's kind of gross. In some parts of India, people will wash their eyes with the first urine of the day to prevent sore eyes permanently. So I guess you could try that if you couldn't get yourself an eclipse viewing sunglass. But personally, I think I'd rather burn my eyes out. I still remember the last solar eclipse I saw, not a total one, but a partial. And I remember our teachers taking us outside and giving us pieces of paper, and we would poke holes in the paper, and you could see the shadow of the eclipse through the holes. But unfortunately for this one, I am in New York, so it's too far for me to travel to see a total eclipse. But those of you guys who are seeing it, have a great time, take some photos, and don't forget to turn those utensils upside down. Also, if you're not in the US or you're traveling somewhere and you missed it, don't worry, another one will be around in about 7 years. All right, guys, thank you all so much for watching. Again, happy Total Eclipse Day. I'll see you later.